This video demonstrates how to use Pycharm Professional to SSH into remote server. This is the easiest way to use remote SSH. The best part is that your workflow stays exactly the same. You just use Python install on your Raspberry Pi or another Linux computer instead of your host desktop or laptop. This is my preferred workflow and you will see it used repeatedly throughout this series. The only downside that is it relies on Pycharm Professional, a paid application. That is why I showed a free alternative using JupyterLab in the previous video. So let's begin. Let's open Pycharm Pro and either open an existing project or create a new empty one on your Windows desktop. I am using the existing project called scripts located at d/anaconda/scripts. My project's folder structure looks something like this. After successful configuration, Pycharm will create an exact copy on the remote Raspberry Pi. For this demonstration, I will create a new Python file and give it a name rp_test, and then we will click on the settings and then in project scripts click on Python interpreter and click on add interpreter and click on SSH. A new SSH window will appear. Let's create a new SSH connection using the default settings. In the host field, enter your Raspberry Pi's IP address. And finally, use your Raspberry Pi's default username, Pi in my case. Keep the port number at its default settings. Click Next. Pycharm will try connecting. If everything runs smoothly, you will then be prompted for your Raspberry Pi password. Enter it. Click Next. Then click it again. A new window will appear. There, we will need to use the existing environment. Make sure to check the existing box. Next, in the interpreter's drop-down menu, select the Python installation we configured in the previous video using Miniconda and the virtual environment called Context. If you recall, we created Context virtual environment with Python 3.12. Let's use that one. Now, the sync folder is crucial. Choose wisely. The default TMP folder on the Raspberry Pi is cumbersome to navigate. It's much better to use the script folder we created on the Pi. Then click Create. Then click OK. To confirm we are using the correct remote Python environment on the Raspberry Pi. The easiest way is to check the installed libraries. In the previous video, we installed the YFinance library within that environment. So we can see it's present here, confirming our setup. Click OK and click Apply. Let's create a simple test Raspberry Pi script. I will show you how to locate this file remotely on your Raspberry Pi within Pycharm. And then I will show you the file itself on the Raspberry Pi. Initially, the remote host icon on Pycharm may not be visible. You will need to click the three dots, select remote host, and then you can browse your files on the remote Raspberry Pi host, like I am doing right now. Our newly created file is readily available. We will now access our Raspberry Pi's desktop environment via VNC Viewer. Once there, we will look at the file. Double click it and you will see its contents, and our SSH setup is complete. So in the next video, we will create a script which will speak out loud the economic events, upcoming holidays, current SGX quote, etc. So stay tuned and subscribe for early notifications. See you in the next one.